Hi guys, today we will be discussing about the steps of creating a pluggable enabled container database, which is a new feature in Oracle 12c. So the container database can be created in different options. One, by using the create database SQL command with the enable pluggable option. The second is that using DBCA in graphical user interface mode. Third, DBCA in the SAN mode. And the fourth, by from an existing container database using Armon, either you can recover or you can do a cloning. Using that Armon, you can create the a container database. In today's example, we'll be seeing how to create a container database using the graphical user interface method of DBCA. We'll see the practicals of it. I have already installed Oracle 12c in this machine. This is the Oracle home. That is why should Oracle product 12.0.db_1 is the Oracle home. I am in the bin directory. Let me invoke the DBCA. Okay, DBCA is ready. We'll select the option create database. Next. Okay, here there is one basic default configuration and the advanced mode is there. So I'll select the advanced mode. Next. The template, as we have seen in Oracle 11g, we do have the different templates. I'll select the general purpose or transaction processing templates. Next. The name of the database, I'll give us new DB. Okay, here you can see that there is an option like create as a container database. So I'll select the option create as a container database. Then I do have the two options. One, create an empty container database. So when you select the empty container database, it will create only the root container. It will not create any pluggable database. It will create a root container as well as it will create a seed pluggable database, which is default, but it will not create any user defined pluggable database. So if you wanted to create a pluggable database, a user-defined pluggable database, then you can give the number of pluggable database and the name of the pluggable database. In this example, we'll create an empty container database. So I'll select that option. Next. If you wanted to configure the interface database express, you can enable the next option. For this example, I'm not going ahead with that. I'm disabling the option to enable Enterprise Database Express. Okay, then give the password for the sys and system user. I'll give the password as Oracle. The default listener, it will be in this 12c version of the DBCA. During the database creation, what are the listeners available? It will show the status of the listener. So if you want your database to dynamically register with that particular listener, you can select it. Otherwise, if you wanted to create a new listener, you can select the option of creating a new listener. So I'm selecting the option of registering with the existing running listener. I'm not creating a new listener here. Next. The file system, I select that all the things as a default values, enable the archiving. Next. I'm not enabling the database vault or label security, which I'll be explaining on further classes. Next. Okay, now how much memory that you wanted to give? I'll give the memory as 800 MB. Next. Create the database. So here we have three options are there, as like that of the previous 11g DBC option, that you can create the database, you can create a template, or you can create the database creation steps. So in this example we'll not be creating the scripts, we'll just create the database. So select that option to create the database and click on next. We'll get a database configuration assistant summary. Go through it. Make sure that all the setups are correct and click on finish. It is going to create the database for us. Hope this session is clear. We'll continue in the next session how to create the container database using the scripts. Thank you.